Welcome to this tutorial for the IPTV system that's installed in most of the apartments on our resort here in Clube, Albufeira. When the system boots up for the very first time, providing it's been correctly configured and is connected to the internet via Wi-Fi or directly plugged into the router, this is the screen that you will be eventually presented to once it's gone through its boot up process. This is the main screen, and by default, the column it selects at the start is the TV column, and this TV column represents all channels that are available that are currently being broadcasted live now. And using the up, down, left and right buttons and on the remote, we can see the different categories here. We have Premier League, we have pay-per-view events, we have adult channels, we have the entertainment, which is basically the main terrestrial channels, ITV, BBC One, etc. And we also have movies, kids, and Sky Sports. Let's just take Sky Sports for example. If we press the OK button, we're presented with the main menu. And we can see here that you have a choice of, for example, on the Formula One channel, a standard definition, HD, which is 720p, and full HD, which is 1080p, which is broadcasting currently right now. As you can see, we can choose the channels we want and push the OK button, and then the channel appears on the right. Push the OK button again, it goes full screen. Hit the back button and hit the back button again. It will bring us back to the original front screen. These particular channels here are available 24/7. There is no buffering. If you've got a good internet connection, as I mentioned, you really should not have any issues. The system's updated very regularly, and we've been using this system now for a little over 2 years, and we've had little or no problems with it at all, apart from finger problems, which is why I've actually done this tutorial. The other features we have on the live TV channels is something called catch-up. So there's no need to try and recall programs. This system will keep it on the servers for up to 2 weeks. So if you want to watch something that you've missed, say it happened yesterday or earlier on this morning, if you go to the channel that you're interested in, so if we click on, I'll go entertainment, because this is going to bring up the main terrestrial channels. And let's say we want to watch something on ITV. As you can see, the channels with the orange clock next to the number, that denotes this is a channel that can be used for catch-up service. If it doesn't have this, then you cannot use this. So we're going to look for something that happened on ITV, say yesterday. Don't know what yet, but we've picked something when we find it. If you click on the right arrow on the remote, you will be presented with a screen that shows you a list of the channels that are available. And again, as you can see, today's date is listed. And if you use the up button, we move it to yesterday and click OK. We will now see the channels and that were available yesterday. So let's just say Emmerdale from yesterday, we select it, click the OK button, and then that program will start to play once it's buffered the initial start of it. And that's it really, and then we can use the controls to fast forward it, rewind it, pause it, stop it, just like a DVR. And it's very handy, and like I said, this actually goes up to 2 weeks. I'm going to stop this now, and then click the backup button, and backup button again, and move the cursor to the right. Everything away from the TV column represents something that's been recorded previously. So either a movie, box set, a drama, a documentary, or whatever, and you find it either from here or from here, which is the TV series column. But let's go back to the video club. If we click on 2019, this will show us all things that have happened, like movies. This is really a way of getting into the latest movies. So as you can see on the column there, you can see when it was added, and sometimes that's as soon as today. You may go on there today and it might have been added at 1 o'clock in the morning, so you can see that it's just been added. 99.9% of these films or programs are in very good condition. They're not cams, they're not, you know, the awkward grainy stuff you see on other systems. If it's on here, it's normally a very good quality version of it, and often in HD, as you can see. You can pick the particular film or program that you're interested in. You can move it to the right or click on the info button, and you will see a little bit more information about that particular program, film, or program that you're trying to watch. And if you're happy with what you see, you hit the OK button, and then that particular film or show will start to play. And again, you have the full controls of fast forward, rewind, pausing, and stopping. So I'm going to stop that again there. So there are, as you can see, many, many films. We have 200 here at the moment, and we have some stuff that's in the cinemas right now or recently released. So it's quite up to date. It's better than the Sky system. You, I think, have to wait 6 months on the Sky system before you see anything that's been released or currently in the cinemas. So this actually gets it to you quicker. I'm going to hit the back button now and then move it to the right to the TV series. This is where they have a predetermined amount of programs. They think these are the common ones that people want to do. So they actually made it very easy to find. So they have every single program of every series under one tab. So if we go up to, let's just say, for example, air crash investigation, we click OK. There's often a sub menu here, and it's indicating that it's in HD. We click it again, and now we get all the seasons right from the very start. And then you just select the season you want and what episode you want also, and click OK. And then that particular program will start to play. And again, you have the fast forward, rewind, stop, and pause functions available to you. Okay, I'm just going to hit back up and back up there. We also have radio channels. So if we click OK, we can have a few channels there, BBC One, Capital Radio. So these are mostly the UK channels there, but all you do is click on the OK and you will start to hear that channel broadcasted live. Okay, that pretty much covers the basis of this system. Thanks for watching.